Hi, this is John Powell from the AT&T Developer Marketing Program. In this short video quick tip, I'm going to talk about the in-app messaging API and show you how to get started using it here at developer.att.com. In-app messaging is a peer-to-peer messaging API giving developers the ability to bring the AT&T messaging platform directly into their app. Once the app is integrated, the AT&T messaging user can send and receive messages to anyone across any U.S. carrier using their existing 10-digit mobile number. Here on the developer site, you'll see that we're already on the overview page for in-app messaging. And what you can do to get started is select the API list drop-down, select Docs, and then on the Docs page, you'll see that there's a lot of information to look at, and you want to make sure that you take a few minutes to do that before you jump in and get started to make sure that you have the information you need from the environment that you're working in. One of the things I want to focus on today before we leave the Docs page is items around OAuth and considerations you need to understand here. The first thing that I want to talk about here is end user consent. The in-app messaging API requires every end user who's going to use the messaging service through your application to provide explicit consent for your application to have to send messages and receive messages. We won't go into the details of that today, but that's an important consideration. And tied to that, we have our two scopes that are required or are necessary to use these functions. So one is IMMN. This is for sending the message on behalf of the user. And then the second scope here is MIM, or M-I-M. This is basically for retrieving messages and managing the inbox of the end user. So with that, let's jump up to the My Apps page. We'll select that, and then we'll just set up a new app here. I'll click Set Up New App. I'm going to type in an app name, which I already have listed here. I'll take that, and I'll copy it. Alright, so that's required for both the app name and the description. And as you scroll down, you'll see a list of several APIs. These are all the APIs that AT&T offers. In-app messaging is here near the top. Again, you have in-app messaging, IMMN. This is for sending messages on behalf of the user. And then below that, you'll see in-app messaging MIM. This is for managing the inbox of the end user and receiving messages. So again, if you want to have both of these capabilities, you need to select both of these for your app. The second and last step on this page is setting up basically a redirect URL that allows AT&T to redirect the service back to you once that end user has provided consent. So once the end user has provided consent, we send you back an authorization code, and then you can take that authorization code and receive the application token, which you'll need to send and receive calls using the API. So now that the application has been set up, we'll take a quick look at this here. You'll see that we have in-app messaging IMMN and then the MIM scope. Both are added to the APIs as we had requested. And then the second thing you'll see here are the app key for the application and then the secret. Of course, these are two important components that are needed to send and receive calls as well. That's it for this video quick tip. Please stay tuned for more. Thanks.